You can see the different parts of a tree, like stem, leaf, etc. What is it made of? As told by the scientists Schulieden and Schwann, it is made up of cells. Because that is the first postulate of cell theory, all living organisms are made up of cells. And you know, when the cells of same type comes together, we can call it as a tissue. Which are the different types of tissues in plants? Some tissues are there in the growing tips, which is known as meristematic tissue, and all other tissues are known as permanent tissue. In this video, we will discuss about the permanent tissues in plants. For that, we have to take the cross section of the stem so that we can see the internal structure of the stem. This is the internal structure of the stem, and this is an actual figure which is taken through the microscope. And here you can see the cells have got different color. It is because normally cells doesn't have any color. So for identifying each cell, we put stain on the sections so that different cells take up different concentration of stain and they will have different color. So we have used the stain here, and that's how we get different color and we can identify different cells. See the cells in the center, they are of same type. And they have similar structure, their function is also same. So we can call them as simple permanent tissues because all the cells in that group are of same type and all have same function. So we call them as simple permanent tissue. And the cells in the center are known as parenchyma. So that is the first type of simple permanent tissue, parenchyma. Now we will see how it is drawn. Here, see, parenchyma is drawn like this. It can be circular, oval, or polygonal. Now we can see the features. One is the shape itself. Second one, see whether there are intercellular spaces or not. Oval and circular have intercellular space, while polygonal doesn't have any intercellular space. So it may be present or absent. Now third one, what is the cell wall made of? It is made of the normal material, that is cellulose. And fourth one, what is their function? They store food and they give mechanical support also. This is actually the view from the upper side. So it looks circular or oval or polygonal in shape. Now the last point, where they are seen. In this diagram you can see parenchyma are mainly present in the center, and you can see a lot of parenchyma there. So we can say that they are the abundant tissue in plants. Now moving to the second type of tissue. See the diagram. Here in this cross section of the stem, you can see just below the epidermis, many cells are there which has got thickening in their cell walls. And they are known as colenchyma. So we will see how this colenchyma is drawn. This way. They can be circular, oval, or polygonal. And you can see there are thickening in the corners of their cell wall. This is due to the deposition of a material called pectin. So we can move to their points. First one is about the shape itself, same as parenchyma, circular, oval, or polygonal. Second one, what is their cell wall made of? Pectin is there. At the same time, cellulose and hemicellulose is also there. Are there intercellular spaces? No intercellular spaces. Now what is the function? Here due to the deposition of pectin, they give flexibility to the branches of the stem. For example, they are seen in citrus plants and they give flexibility to the branches. Now where are they seen? As I mentioned earlier, they are seen just below the epidermis in the form of patches. Now moving to the third tissue, in the cross section of the stem, you can see red color cells. They are sclerenchyma, the third type of simple permanent tissue. Why they are this much colored? Because of the presence of a material known as lignin. Lignin is the deposition in their cell wall. Now we will see how it is drawn. This is the way to draw sclerenchyma. Now the first point is their cell wall has got deposition of a material called a lignin. They are dead cells and What will be the function? Because of the deposition of this lignin, they are very hard. So they are mainly seen in hard parts of the plant, like nuts, coconut shell, tea leaves, etc. And they give mechanical strength as well as support also. Now, where are they seen? They are seen above the vascular bundle. Vascular bundle means made of xylem and phloem, above the vascular bundle, and sometimes below the epidermis also. One more point, is there an intercellular space for this? No, it is absent. Now when you take sclerenchyma, they are of mainly two types. They are like sclerates and fibers. So two types of sclerenchyma are there, sclerenchyma sclerates and sclerenchyma fibers. So this is about sclerenchyma. So far we discussed three types of simple permanent tissues. They are parenchyma, collenchyma and sclerenchyma. Now the next type is complex permanent tissues. We will discuss that in another video. Thank you.